not like, of course, 100%. It tastes a combination of different types of coffees, but of course we are not there yet with the, like, the commercial variety. But it certainly does resemble coffee at the moment. There's a noticeable roasted odor. Then depending on the roast level, it can be also quite fruity, quite green, quite honey-like actually, surprisingly. We have, at the moment, we have different roast levels and different, like, growth parameters in our coffees. And once we, and now we of course want to just see, is there a discernible difference and in what direction does it go? So, for example, the hypothesis goes that when you increase the roasting temperature, roasting duration, the bitterness and roasted odor intensity should increase.
We propose an alternative process here. We skip the farming part and we use plant cell cultures instead. So actually real coffee cell cultures, but they are not generated in the field, but instead we are growing them in bioreactors. So the main idea with all these processes, basically using the cellular agriculture to substitute agricultural commodities, is of course to have a better sustainable process. So the idea is really in the long term to indeed substitute agricultural processes, and that's of course because we have a more sustainable process here. If we think about a bioreactor cultivation, for example, so you have to keep in mind that this is a totally contained and closed system. So there is no contaminations in there. You don't need pesticides, let's say, to ward off pests, or you don't need excess fertilizer which would go into the ground, things like that. So you can recirculate even the nutrient medium, which is of course still needed, and so on.
So a decade ago we were talking about the impact of climate change, what it might mean, and now climate change is front and center for the coffee industry, because we're seeing throughout the tropical coffee belt farmers being impacted by climate change, increasing temperatures, but also more erratic rainfall and increased drought.
Well, that's quite a question. I think someday, of course, because I think we're going that way because of all the natural coffee sources like are vanishing, so we have to move along. But yes, I think when the day comes and if it tastes, then it's like the aroma is coffee based. So why not? I think it's possible.